Hey science friends, right now I'm at the biobase and we are gonna go on an adventure to find water bears.
Water bear don't care. Tardigrades, they're cute, they're tiny, and they're pretty tough. These eight-legged animals can survive almost anything and live almost everywhere. And today I'm gonna show you how to find them. And joining us, I brought Dr. Ben, founder of the Biobus, and here's Valeria. She's an engineering student with sick photography skills, and she'll be filming the action. To get started, you'll need some simple materials. An envelope, a small knife, and a microscope. And the magnification doesn't even have to be crazy.
Finding those water bears, wherever you are, gonna find ya. So where you find moss, you might find water bears. And in this corridor, there seems to be a lot of moss.
So yeah, let's go. Step one, find the moss, collect the moss.
In order to collect the water bears, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna use a simple knife and an envelope.
And here's another tip. Collect a variety of moss and be thorough to increase your chances of finding those tardigrades.
As a kid, you're encouraged to play in the dirt. And as an adult, you should still play in the dirt. You'll be surprised at what you can find. Whoa, what in the world? Why is this up there? Definitely not a water bear. To you and I, a tree is just a tree. But if you are the size of a water bear, this tree is like a planet.
Or maybe it's more like a continent. But regardless, water bears live in the trees as well. So you want to scrape out as much lichen and moss as possible. Get in those crevices, get in those cracks, get lots of moss. And once you have your samples, you take it back to the base. And in this case, it's the biobase. Now, water bears can enter a state called cryptobiosis when they sense that it's too dry. They dry themselves out like raisins and shrivel up. And it's in that cryptobiotic state that water bears can survive without oxygen, without food, without water. And that's why water bears are really tough. To reanimate the water bears, we're gonna use some good old H2O. But not just any H2O, we're talking about that spring water or distilled water, because tap water can kill some of the microorganisms. Water bears do care about that.
So now that the moss is rehydrated, if there are any microorganisms in cryptobiosis, they'll sense that there's water around them and they'll reanimate, so to speak.
Now, it can take a couple of hours to reanimate, but this is YouTube, so we're just gonna skip that. So now we grab the moss and we squeeze it out into another container. If there's any water bears or other creatures in there, they'll fall out with the water. Now we're on the hunt for those water bears. What do you see, Dr. Ben? Oh, well, that's a nematode or a small worm. Those are pretty cool too. But we're looking for those water bears. Let's see what Valeria finds. And that eyebrow is saying that she doesn't see a thing. But now, Dr. Ben, what do you see? Do you see a water bear?
Daddy, that's a bear.
Not a bear.
So whatever that thing is, it's not the microorganism that we're looking for. We continue searching, but we're not having any luck. So let's go to day two. Yeah, here we are, day two at the New York Hall of Science, and check out this tree right here. All of that lichen. So here we go again. You collect the moss, getting in all those cracks and crevices, getting different parts of the tree, being thorough, like a pro. Look at that moss down there. That's that fluffy moss. If you were a water bear, you would probably want to be in there because it's going to be moist and you can hang out all you want. So let's take this moss and check it out. So here we are, new location, moss rehydrated, searching through, and bam! There you go, water bear in your face.
We found the water bear, we found the tardigrade, we found the water bear, it's time to celebrate.
So that was our water bear adventure. And if you decide to go searching for tardigrades, share your adventure with me via social media, because doing science is awesome. Thanks for watching, hit subscribe, and I'll see you next time.